Okay, now we go back to our demo production. Okay, so you have your assignment. So this one, now the student will see this. And the good thing about this system is they can see on their handphone as the page on the handphone. Normally what happens, our website will be not centigrade, will be, but on the handphone they can move this way. So now they can see directly orange. It's due on 9th December. They don't have to look which day is orange. If it is mera, it will become red when it's already past the day.
It will
become red. It will change color. Okay, change the color. Okay? Now we add on the activity resource. You add activity resource. Add activity resource. And then I show you how to use the big blue button inside. So you want to make a class, you click here, big blue button. Okay, add. Now big blue button is only for live class, don't use for recorded class, okay? So room activity with recordings, virtual classroom name you have to give, for example PPST demo, PPST demo BBD, demo BBD, and then we have the activity room setting, so you have your activity room, welcome message, wait for moderator, this session can be recorded if the student wants to record on their own. If you don't want the student to record, click on that. The student will be recording on your own, remember, so if you don't want them to record, you click on that. Okay. Recording session. Okay, so wait for moderator. Now this is all users enrolled. Suppose you have a class of 50 and then you're teaching, you want to teach only a group of 6, you can use the names of the users here. So I can add the users which I want, the remaining user I can delete. So, or you can use participant list. Okay, so schedule for session and then also. We have already everything. Okay, so you have your virtual classroom name. You can click in your link here as well. You can click and put in your link. Okay, go down. Save. Okay, wow. It will be gone to the schedule. Okay. So this is the schedule for your class. So suppose your class is 9 to 11 on the 15th of December, you can put here. Schedule for class 9 to 11. So you can put your class when they join and when they open. But make sure that when you log on to Big Blue, you follow the same time, otherwise they will come and there is no class. Okay, common module settings. Okay, and then you restrict, usually you restrict access to outsiders if you don't want to block it. Activity completion, click here. Okay. So, click, drop down the box. Okay, so this is one of the thing for tracking the student. Remember, when, if you want to track using analytics, you have two options. One student can manually mark the activity as completed, which means when the student attend your class, they will have to click on the button. Then it will show as completed. But as a teacher, you want to have it automatic, right? So you should say show activity as complete when condition met, which means if the student watch your lecture and they maybe you give them assignment only when they meet the condition, accept.
Yeah.
So usually we have this show condition activity when condition are met. Okay. Okay, so click on that, select, and then expected completion. So this usually you give on the one day after your lecture, because assuming the student have watched the lecture, maybe one day later you will get the notification. Don't do it too close to the lecture, or sometimes the network and all issues. Okay, these are the tags. So these are the tag hashtag. Suppose you want to hashtag your lecture, for example, hashtag physics or hashtag electronics for semiconductor, you can hashtag with those words. That makes it searchable on the database, okay, on the Google search engine. That's it. And then competency. Okay, competency basically tells you the level of the, see, upon click search, upon completion of the activity, sometimes you may ask them to review the lecture, attach evidence as file. Okay, view my lecture, you can attach the evidence as well. Okay. So once all this is done, you save and display. Yeah. Activity, usually sometimes, but in our system, what we are doing, we are giving them a lecture and then we are giving them assignment. Okay. So, because of the culture of UMS, please use the same system. Watch my lecture and then complete the assignment. So, you have to add one activity is the lecture and the assignment separately. Don't integrate it together, the student may get confused. Okay. If you all want me to come and give a talk to the student, maybe I can come in your class. Your class will be active, right? You call me, I will teach them how to use, else they will get confused. Okay. Okay, so this is the one. So now you click on the session join. So this is making use of big blue button session. So there's some pre-configured, it should replace the production. Okay, so you can join the session. So once you click, you can join the session. Okay. Alternatively, if you want to make Big Blue Button available as a web page, you can do that as well. Okay, so click, go down to the main page, save and display. It's done, right? Okay, so Big Blue Button has been set. Okay, introduction. Okay, add an activity or resource. Okay, add an activity or resource. So now, if you want to make the, if you want to use Big Blue Button, which you set in your class, right? You have set it, you are not configured in the system. You can click add a web page, go down to web page, or you can add URL, okay? You have two options, one is to add URL, okay? Add
URL.
Yeah, add URL. Okay, so this URL will be named class 1. For example, you want, now you have created in your own Big Blue Button, you created a class, right? But you have not used the system. You want to use the alternative way. You name it class 1. In the external URL, you put the Big Blue Button URL which you created. That's your class, okay? And then this will be your description of your class. And then you just put www.bigbluebutton.com. Just put Big Blue Button.
Blue button.
Actually, I think I should, later I should come to your class. How many students do you have in each class starting? So one class where everyone come together?
It's for the lecture, for 70 per class.
You'll have it in the hall?
Yeah,
so the 70 means the full intake?
No, per class.
Okay. So we'll have four times, right? So maybe I have to demo to them. I'll have to demo the student.
Oh.
Maybe you have to call me because it's easier, better for you all later. So maybe you can call me when each class I will come four times and demo the student what they can do in the system.
There is no video in
other supplements, video is hard to
explain. For the student,
but then the student want to see, they don't, they prefer video, not face to face.
I prefer video online.
Okay, then I can make for them. So I'll enroll as a student, and I'll enroll and say, in order to enroll as a student, this is for the student. But if you need help, you please call, because that's our job.
For the earliest guidance, I think video is okay.
Video is okay. Okay. So we do video. But if you need assistance, you call us, we will come and help you.
Yeah.
Okay, so click here to list something. You just write class, my class. My class. In this one, you can write your learning outcome and everything else. Appearance and add display description on the. Remember this one, huh? This one, you should always click here. Save, click here. You know why you have to click on that? Because when you see on the handphone, you cannot see the links. But when you click description of the first page, you will see the link on the first page. So that's very important on this. You must always click on that, and then you, this one you can all adjust accordingly. It's our default, and then save. Save and display. So all the instructions